Hi, I'm Greg Mathison, the Chief Operating Officer for Newfound Gold Corp. And joined today here with Christopher Baker, one of our project geologists here at the Queens Bay Project in central Newfoundland. So if I recall, Chris, you're the guy who had planned the original drill hole into the iceberg zone, drill hole 22-1084. That was the very last drill hole of our 2022 campaign, and the drillers were supposed to stop drilling that day, and I guess they didn't get the memo.
No, I told them to keep rolling. Basically, we had seen quite a large deformation corridor with some mineralization the hole prior, so of course we had to investigate that further, and 1084 was the discovery.
Yeah, so we came along, a dilational portion, I guess, of that structure, and you know, that's what we've been following ever since.
Latest release from Iceberg, hole 1210. We've intercepted 105 grams per ton over 27.1 meters. Basically, this hole is a 50 meter step back from the discovery hole 1084, and it's about 30 meters along strike of hole 1120, which was another bonanza grade zone. 49.7 grams per ton over 29.9 meters.
Within the core of the iceberg zone, which certainly 1210 represents, we see a very consistent fault structure, vein domains, and of course, mineralization. This is one of the spectacular holes that we've had to date within the iceberg zone, and it's been a really exciting discovery for the company here in 2023. Oftentimes within there, you're seeing hundreds, if not well over 1,000 visible gold grains just on the surface of the drill core.
So this is a vein from 80.35 to 81.35 meters downhole. It graded 757 grams per ton over that meter. There's quite a bit of gold in there.
In addition, obviously, to the spectacular interval that we have in drill hole 1210, I think more significantly here at Iceberg, we're seeing a lot of expansion with this zone. That included an extension 375 meters beyond where 1210 is, which intersected 21.7 grams per ton gold over 4.45 meters. We've really seen a tenfold increase of the iceberg zone. This structure, we do think, is likely the fault displacement of the Keats baseline fault, which is the key host structure there at the main Keats zone. And it looks like it was displaced about 300 meters to the north, but you know, that combined strike length is over 1.8 kilometers of really continuous mineralization along the Keats baseline structure. That zone still remains open in all directions at this point. The company's still very active at the iceberg. We've got a number of drilling rigs on that, and it looks like it'll be continued focus for us for a good portion of 2023. We're always looking forward to seeing what's coming out of this zone next.